Welcome to Simply Fun's How to Play Lily Pond, a game where players hop their frogs around the pond, collecting the letters found on their word cards. You can play Lily Pond with 2 to 4 players ages 4 and up. Lily Pond is good for developing foundational reading skills, as players learn to recognize the alphabet while moving their pawns around the game board and finding the letters on their cards. Lily Pond also helps with spelling, as players identify letters in the order they appear on their cards to spell a word. Place the game board in the center of the play area within reach of all players. Each player selects a frog and places it on the rocks in the center of the pond, then takes a letter tracker that matches the color of their frog. Separate the cards by color and shuffle each set separately. There are 3 decks: green with 3-letter words, light blue with 4-letter words, and dark blue with 5-letter words. Deal a card from each deck to each of the players for a total of 3 cards. Players choose what order they want to play the cards in and place them on the table for all to see. Then place the letter tracker on the first letter of the first card to show what letter they need to find. Place the remaining cards back in the box. Players take turns hopping their frog around the pond on the game board so that they land on or jump through the lily pad letters they need for their words. The first player to hop on or through their letters in the correct order and then hop back to the center rocks wins the game. Basic movement. On your turn, roll the die and hop your frog that number of spaces toward the letter selected by your tracker. You may move your frog to any lily pad connected by lines. Use every move in your roll. You cannot stop early. After you've completed your move, review and say the letters you've passed. You are not allowed to land on or pass over the same lily pad letter more than once during your turn. If the same letter appears more than once on the same card, like in Apple, you only get to record it once during a turn. Jumping over frogs. If a lily pad is occupied by another frog, you cannot land there, but you can jump over it. When jumping over another frog, the occupied space is not counted as part of your roll, and the letter the other frog is sitting on cannot be collected. The center rocks. When moving your frog, you may land on or move across the rocks space in the center of the game board. The rocks count as a single space and must be counted during your move. Unlike lily pads, the rocks can be shared by other frogs. Spelling words. To spell your words, hop on or through the letter currently marked by your tracker. After you've reached that letter, move your tracker to the next letter in the word. If you can hop on more than one letter from your word, in the correct order, move the tracker forward for each letter. Watch other players closely. When another player hops on the letter marked by your tracker, you can move your tracker forward to the next letter. When you've completed a word card, even if you're not the active player, say the name of each letter in the order they appear on the card, and then say the word that you just spelled. Now turn the card over and move your tracker to the first letter of your next card. The first player to hop through all the letters on their word cards and move their frog back to the rocks in the center of the game board wins the game. To simplify the game for beginners, you can play using only the 3-letter words. You can also scale up the difficulty as players learn, eventually using only the 5-letter words. Develop and expand foundational reading and spelling skills with Lily Pond. Hop to it!